Now, if you own a plug-in hybrid, you might be wondering what those different drive modes are on the inside. They could say things like hybrid or electric or battery hole, sport mode, all sorts. What on earth is the difference? Well, in this video, I'm going to run through each one and demonstrate its capabilities on the road. Now, it's important to note the differences between a mild hybrid and a plug-in hybrid. Now, this video is for a plug-in hybrid. I do have a video on the differences between mild hybrid and plug-in hybrid, but basically it is what it says on the tin. A plug-in hybrid is one where you plug in and you can actually drive on electric. So let's have a look at these different drive modes. Now, in a plug-in hybrid, as I mentioned, there are various different modes. The way to change this is, of course, dynamic up here in this particular car. So have a look around the car. Somewhere, usually in the middle of the car, there'll be a button to change it. In this, it's a toggle switch just here. And you basically toggle this up and down, and you'll see there are different drive modes from individual, sport, hybrid, electric, battery hold, and off-road in this particular car. Now, hybrids usually, and plug-in hybrids, I should add, will normally just use electric all the way up until their range runs out, and then it will just switch over to the engine automatically. And the cool thing is you just plug it in when you can and it will charge back up again. There may be a few times where you might want to change this, and I don't know, say you're leaving first thing in the morning, driving to London, but you want to save the electric when you're in London, for example. This is where you'll want to change the modes. Normally you don't need to touch the modes, the car just does it all for you, but you can change the modes if you want to. So I think the best thing to do is have a little drive on the road and show you what they can do. So currently right now, I'm in a mode called hybrid. Now, this is exactly what I've just described. It's going to run on electric, just as it is like this. You can see as I go to accelerate, the power will go up. And when I brake, it will charge and put some of that power back into the battery. Now, if you go to accelerate hard, the engine will come on. And suddenly you've got the engine as well. So it's like the perfect all-rounder. You never need to change it. But there are a few settings to change in case you do. Well, the next one down from this is called electric. So this is quite literally exactly the same as the previous mode, hybrid. Electric basically has what I describe as almost like a pressure point on the accelerator pedal. Before, when you press hard on the accelerator pedal, it'll put the engine on, but now look what happens. If I press hard, it's just electric. Now, if I press really hard, I can get past that pressure point and actually get the engine to come on, but it kind of encourages you as a driver to stay on electric, thereby not having the engine on. So both modes are like almost identical, but one's just got like a small pressure point. Underneath this, we have a mode called battery hold. Now, this kind of does what it says on the tin. This will hold the battery where it is and kind of save it for a future point in the journey, for example. So say you're going to go to a city center or London or something like that. Say you want to save that for when you get there, put it on battery hold, it will hold the battery where it is. And then I know what you're thinking, I'm on battery hold at the moment, why hasn't the engine come on? Well, that's because there's still a tiny bit of power left on that percentage, but it will lock it off where it is. So for example, if I slow down here and then need to accelerate again, the engine just comes on a lot sooner and it will just keep that kind of battery percentage locked off where it is. So yes, the engine will still turn off and it will help with the acceleration on electric, but will keep that battery where it is. So notice here, gone back to electric again and the engine's just come back on again. It will go on and off seamlessly and you don't even notice it. The only time you notice it is when you're looking at the revs. Now on this particular car, there's an off-road mode. This is because it's mainly an SUV. And when you select it, it says driving and parking systems are being adapted. For this reason, only use the drive program for driving off-road and not on public roads. Now, this is literally just an off-road mode for going like down a cobble track, or say you're literally about to go that way, kind of off-road or something. But now I don't do any off-roading, so I can't really comment on the exact specifics it does, but I would imagine it probably just optimizes the difference between front-wheel drive and rear-wheel drive using the 4MATIC system that Mercedes-Benz use four-wheel drive in this car. But yes, sadly I can't take this car off-road, as I'm sure someone will probably get angry with me because there's lots of horses around, and also I'm sure Mercedes-Benz wouldn't appreciate that. But in this particular car also, it will raise the suspension in the off-road mode, giving it a bit more ground clearance. Now, for those with a keen eye, will have noticed that there is a sport mode as well. And this also does what it says on the tin, but this is where it will use the engine and the electric motor combined to give you a whole load of power. You know what happens when there's a clear road in front of us and there's no one behind? I hope you're holding on. God, it's so powerful. That's 40, literally. So this is where we use the electric motor and the engine combined to give you all the horsepower it can give. And it's quick. It's like having an electric car and an engine together. Now, obviously, the electric motor in this is not as powerful as like an electric car, but combined with the engine, it's really, really punchy. So very, very useful if you need to overtake someone or just pull out on a slip road or something like that, just in case you need that burst of power. Now, for those with a keen eye will probably notice there's another mode called individual. Now, this is your own individual mode. So, of course, when you change it from normal mode, the hybrid mode, to sport mode, it will make the suspension firmer. But say you don't want that. Say you want the sporty everything, but you want the softer suspension. So in this car, you can adapt that. You can't do that in every car. Just depends if the car has like adaptable suspension. But yeah, if you put it in individual, you can customize your own drive mode. Pretty cool. But for the most part, you're probably just going to keep it in hybrid and basically plug in your plug-in hybrid whenever you can to run on electric, because it's so much cheaper than running on fuel. But there are different drive modes in case you want to choose when you drive on electric. So there we go then, guys. That concludes this week's video on how these different driving modes work in a plug-in hybrid. Now, if you have any questions, let me know in the comments section down below. And of course, thank you so much for watching. And I'd also like to give out a huge shout out to Mercedes for supplying this car so I can make the review video, which I'm going to link literally just here. And then also this video on the different drive modes you could do. But thank you so much for watching. See you next time.